No, we're not going to have that. I want to ask you, let's talk about the time. The gentleman brought up this issue of time. What is the statute of limitations, and how difficult, if years in fact have elapsed, does this, it becomes even more nebulous, it seems.
Well, the statute question is really Dick's question, but I think that what this does bring out is that women frequently don't come forward when it happens. I think that Ms. Hill told us earlier this morning that she was concerned for her job, she was concerned for her advancement, and that is one of the reasons that makes sexual harassment so offensive, is that it's hard to fight back at the time when you're worried that this person who is your supervisor can prevent you from advancing in your job. If you're the least bit ambitious, this person can call a halt to your career. And I think that that's one of the reasons that she did not come forward.
But many years
have
passed since then, though.
She
left the EOC and went to Oral Roberts.
That's absolutely true. One of the reasons we do have a statute of limitations is that it will be very difficult for Judge Thomas to prove that he didn't do these things.
Can we get
a
frame of reference here? How does statute of limitations work?
You have 300 days to file with the EEOC.
From the time the
activity took place, so it's just under a year. And then they investigate, and then you're given a right to sue letter. But essentially focusing on her situation, she would have had 300 days from the time the alleged offensive conduct took place to file her charge. Now, there are some underlying reasons, and you're talking to a defense lawyer here.
Okay, we'll keep that in mind.
Keep that in mind. But as we're seeing now, as Bill was bringing out, to try and to prove a negative, I didn't do it, 8-10 years after the fact, when the witnesses are gone, the circumstances have totally changed, memories have faded, there's been no opportunity to get in there and try to get to the bottom of the thing, is extremely difficult for the defendant. And of course, you got to keep in mind, Judge Thomas has had about 14 days to prepare to refute what happened 10 years ago, whereas in the typical case, a case would be brought to trial maybe a year or two after the allegations were made, and there had been much more opportunity to investigate the situation. That's one of the reasons for the statute.
Excuse me, Dick, we have a caller on the line now who'd like to comment. Inez, go ahead with your comments.
Hi, I'd like to say that what people don't need to understand is that as a victim of incest or rape or molestation or the sexual harassment, you learned not to say anything. You're taught yourself to not say anything to protect yourself from any of this garbage that's going on now. You don't have a chance, and once you do speak up, even if it does go to court, you are still blackballed. She may never have a career after this, regardless if it's true or not.
You know, echoing what Inez says, I was reading the Los Angeles Times this morning that a number of women are siding with Anita Hill, maybe not because of her story specifically, but because they recall incidents throughout the course of their life of sexual harassment by men. So you're reaching something that goes to the core. And I think this is what's coming out, how deeply rooted this is. We don't even know how to sort it out. But for the first time, it is coming out. And you're hearing, I've heard talk shows under every kind of venue, even more than the Persian, you know, Gulf War, that people want to talk about it. Now it's okay to talk about it.
Let's take another phone call. Bonnie in Chula Vista, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hello. This is Bonnie, and I would like to specify something in favor of Judge Thomas, okay? She specified just a few moments ago that she was a religious person. She was brought up with 13 children, which they are overplaying, all right? In my estimation, there is no job, if you're that religious, that makes that much difference to ruin a man's career. That man has strived. He's a black man. He's came from nowhere. He strived, he struggled, and now I believe that there's been a payoff somewhere. That's what I feel in my heart. I can see it.
Okay, thank you for that.
Anita Hill is a witness, an assessment in terms of credibility and how much this is going to, as I think you said earlier, the American public is going to decide this really rather than the Senate Judiciary Committee in the U.S. Senate. How credible is she?
I think we've heard primarily direct examination of Ms. Hill. The tale will be told after Senator Hatch is done. He's going to be really the one, as I understand it, who will be cross-examining her. And I really think the public will make its decision on this case after he has cross-examined her. So I think we need to kind of stay tuned and see how that goes.
a nation staying tuned. Kate, did you have something to add to that?
I think that Ms. Hill makes a very credible witness. I think that it really has taken a woman in her position to come forward, someone who has, from what I can tell, nothing to gain by making these accusations about Judge Thomas. So I think for that reason, I think that she does make a credible witness. Mm.
We have a lot more to talk about on this issue. We'd like to hear from more of you as well. Also on our phone poll, should Clarence Thomas be confirmed based on what you've heard so far this morning? Call 237-6215 if you feel he should be. Call 237-6303 if you feel he should not be confirmed.
And we're going to take another quick break and we'll be right back. Just a couple minutes.
There are some things you can count on every day, like the kids raiding the refrigerator and key buys from Lucky to fill it back up. Hormel chili with beans, a country favorite in regular or hot. Sunshine crispy crackers, regular, unsalted, or whole wheat. And now you can save $6 to fly with E.T. at Universal Studios Hollywood.
Proven lower Lucky prices. Count on that every day.
On Friday and Saturday, the Broadway presents 2 days and nights of savings. The Broadway Night and Day Sale, a sale so big we have to stay closed an extra hour on Friday just to get ready. Save 20 to 50% throughout the store on fashions and accessories for men, women, young men, juniors, and West Coast kids. You'll find savings of 20 to 50% on housewares, linens, furniture, electronics, and home entertaining. 11 to 11 Friday, 8 to 10 Saturday, the Night and Day Sale at the Broadway.
Through the years, the mothers of America have had a kind of medical training.
Next.
They've learned from countless doctors and pharmacists that the way to take care of a cough is with Robitussin. And now at home, the mothers of America are putting this advice to work.
Next.
Robitussin, recommended by Dr. Mom. Which Robitussin is right for you? Ask your doctor or pharmacist.
In homes everywhere, people are discovering that some plastic knives can't cut the mustard. Some plastic forks lose their teeth. And some plastic spoons go soft in the middle. But Sensations brand knives, forks, and spoons are made of heavy-duty plastic, so they can take what you dish out. Next time, choose Sensations, where every job is a piece of cake. Sensations. Bigger, stronger, better.
Welcome back to Inside San Diego, and we're trying to get as much feedback as we can on what's been going on with the Senate Judiciary hearings into the confirmation of Judge Clarence Thomas. Right now, we're going to go back to our live cameras at the Community Concourse downtown, and we have, who are you, please?
I'm Kimberly Holtz.
What is your opinion? Do you think Judge Clarence Thomas should be confirmed?
I think it's a very serious issue, and the allegations of the witnesses need to be taken seriously. But at the same token, I think sexual harassment is an ambiguous topic, and the parameters are not clearly defined, so I don't think he should be persecuted.
Have you ever been a victim of sexual harassment in any way?
No, but then again, it's hard to define what it is. It could be some casual comment passing by on the street, and if that's considered, then yes, I have. But
interesting. Yeah.
Otherwise, no.
Is there someone else there waiting to talk as well? Go ahead and hand the microphone to the next person, and we'll get a look at them. Go ahead and identify yourself, sir.
Hi, my name is Jeff.
Yes, what's your opinion today?
My opinion is that these allegations are too serious to be brought up at the last minute like this. If these allegations are true, they shouldn't have waited until now to bring them up.
So do you put some blame on the members of the Senate Judiciary Committee who did not bring this to light more than the whole thing of sexual harassment?
Well, if they knew that this was going on earlier, yes, but then also if she waited until I think it was the 25th of September to bring this to the attention of Congress, then it was her fault for waiting so long.
All right, thank you, sir. Who's the next guest we have there? Go ahead and pass the microphone along. Identify yourself, please, ma'am.
My name is Deborah Terry.
Good morning. What's your opinion?
Well, I'm really glad that this is out in the public and that he didn't get confirmed. And I think that it is appalling that the committee knew about this and they just swept it under the rug like they do so many times when it has to do with women and women's issues. So whether or not it comes to pass that they decide it's true or not true, at least now they're open to seeing that America, 50% of America are women, and they can't do that anymore.
All right. Thank you. We appreciate it very much. And now we're going to another medium. We're still on television, but we're going to the telephone right now. And I believe we have Brad on. Is that
Brad's
correct?
Online, huh?
Hello, Brad.
Yes.
Go ahead, Brad. What are your comments? Share them with us.
Yes. This sexual harassment thing just only confirms about how men have to walk on eggshells. I was in the military, and women, my opinion, have weakened it with their pregnancies, their paperwork nightmares of getting transferred and can't stay at certain commands, and sexual harassment.
What if you could have babies?
Anyway, my thing is, when I'm head of a corporation here, and I will not hire them. I don't hire them, and just because of this reason, this all the sexual harassment. You say something and it's wrong, or you get in trouble, or you know, everyone has to walk on eggshells in that office. So I don't hire them. Thank you.
You ever need a good attorney? We got one right here, bud.
That sounds like an EEOC complaint right there, doesn't it? Discrimination, huh?
That's why it's anonymous.
That's why it's only Brad. Yes.
This is what's so fascinating. Do you think that this is a watershed in terms of understanding the changing relationships of men and women in the workplace?
I think so. I'm glad that the issue really is out in the open. Dick and I were discussing earlier that perhaps 10 years ago we really didn't have a name for this activity that was going on in the workplace. Perhaps a woman didn't know that she should have complained. She should have said something both to the harasser and both to her boss. I think that we now have a label for it, and I think it's easier to complain about something that finally has a label. And I think that this will bring it out into the open. I think more women will tell their harassers that no, this is not appropriate behavior. Mm-hmm. I don't find it flattering and it's not welcome. And I think this will give a lot of women the courage, or men who are harassed, the courage to speak up about it.
On the telephone again is Lori from Claremont. Go ahead, Lori. You're on the air with Kate Thixton and Dick Freeman.
Hi, Laura. Hi, Bill.
Hi.
There are so many sides to this issue. It's so complicated. Yet, I think there's a simple remedy in my mind. I don't see anything against Judge Hill being nominated and going to the Supreme Court. I would like him to apologize to Ms. Hill. I think she deserves an apology, a public apology.
All right, thank you for those comments. Of course, an apology might de facto admit that there was something to apologize for. Dick?
Absolutely. I think after the opening statement that Judge Thomas gave this morning, where he categorically denied the allegations, he's set his position in stone. And so I think an apology at this point would be a de facto admission. Mm-hmm. I don't think it'll happen.
Okay. We want to thank you certainly for your time, Kate Thixton and Dick Freeman. Continued good luck to you all. Maybe I was going to say there'll be a little bit more business, but fascinating times we live in, aren't they?
All right. Before we go to a break, we want to remind you folks about our telephone poll. Your opinion, again, should Clarence Thomas be confirmed as a Supreme Court Justice? Yes, the number to call 237-6215. No, 237-6303. Because your response has been so tremendous on this, and as you can see, the no's outweigh the yeses 54% to 46. Because the lines have been so jammed, we are going to keep this poll going through the rest of the afternoon and the evening. We'll update you in the rest of Inside San Diego today, as well as the news at 5, 6:30, and Nightcast at 11.
And coming up next, we're going to give you a full look at news of the day, so stay with us.
Something different. Chicken brushed with La Choy soy sauce. La Choy makes a good thing better.
Your Flex is back.
I started using Flex years ago,
but then they changed it.
Bad idea.
But they got smart and changed it back,
and it's better than ever. Good move, Flex. The see-through bottle, the fragrance we love, balsam and silk protein, Flex shine and manageability are back in our hair. Our Flex is back, so we're back to Flex.
Who says no one gives you anything for free?
Not Arnold's Furniture.
And here's some free advice.
Get ready for the holiday season early.
This week, all Arnold's dining sets, including Thomasville, are marked on a minimum of 30% and up to 50% off.
Or choose from an elite selection of better quality dining sets and receive free the beautiful matching china cabinet.
That's free, with no payments till April.
And I personally guarantee two-day express delivery.
Arnold's, from our family to yours.
Levitt's is celebrating the anniversary of Columbus's greatest discovery with a spectacular sale of fine furniture. Levitt's has cut 20 to 50% off regular prices on everything in stock. These are important savings, greater than you'd normally expect to find, even at a Columbus Day sale. It took Columbus 70 long, hard days to discover the new world, but you're just a few minutes away from the Levitt's near you. Hurry, this sale ends Monday night.
You'll love it at Levitt's.
Welcome back. Our second half, and talk about an abrupt change of pace. Our favorite animal expert, Dr. Dog, a.k.a. Dr. Dennis Fetko, is going to tell you we're going to have a live demonstration of how to handle an incorrigible, that is an undisciplined pet.
Yes, indeedy doo doo. Also, a live contest between California's two fastest bricklayers as they prepare to vie for the title of the fastest trowel in the West.
See what happens when you watch this show?
Everything.
Especially on
Fridays.
We're
so eclectic.
And also, speaking of eclectic, our entertainment reporter Gary Shenda will have the weekend rundown and his opinions on some new films. And are we going to show Yes, we are. How fast a professional pit crew can get a race car on and off the track. You won't believe it.
Jack White returns to us now this morning. Jack, quite an interesting discussion here with all the folks down at the concourse.
I was enjoying it very much. Some interesting comments indeed.
A lot happening. Yes. Thank you for coming back. Nice to see you, sir,
all
with
right.
the news.
It's good to be back. We began this morning with some news that is happening here in San Diego. Police at this hour are looking for a father who allegedly shot and killed an apartment security guard after the guard slapped the man's young son. Now, police say Lau Pele Tutiloma and Keith Carter had been arguing all day at this apartment complex on Ozark Street after Tutiloma slapped Carter's two-year-old son. Now, the child apparently had been creating a disturbance. Officers were called and they cited the security guard for battery. Then about an hour later, neighbors heard gunshots. When police arrived, they found Tutiloma with a gunshot wound to his back. He died a short time later at Mercy Hospital. Police are still looking for Carter, who apparently ran off from the apartment complex. Alert neighbors are now being cited with saving a house from going up in flames in East San Diego last night. Three people walking down a street saw smoke pouring out of a bedroom window from this three-story wooden home on Central Avenue. They didn't waste any time. They woke up the man inside. They grabbed a garden hose, shoved it through the bedroom window, and hosed it down. Investigators say if it hadn't been for those folks, then the house probably would have gone up like a box of matches. The fire apparently started in a mattress. A 10-foot wall of steel is going up this morning at the international border by the Otay Mesa port of entry. Now, as you can see from these pictures from Sky 10, a small section of the fence is already in place. Army reservists started putting up the barrier yesterday, and when the job is done, it will stretch for 6 miles. U.S. border officials hope that the fence will shut down a very popular route for drug and alien smugglers. The fence is not costing the Border Patrol a dime. It is being constructed from surplus military material. A similar barrier is up near the San Ysidro port of entry. For the first time in more than 6 decades, the Naval Training Center here in San Diego will not be taking in any new recruits. These sailors, along with all the others who get there before the end of this month, will finish their 8 weeks of training, but no new recruits will be taken after November the 1st. No new recruits until March of next year, that is. A need for fewer recruits and cuts in the defense budget are forcing the Navy to skip some training classes. Some of the small businesses in the area will suffer, but the Navy says it will save the taxpayers a great deal of money in the long run. Budget cuts are also hitting many schools throughout the county. The corners are being cut and some schools are eliminating classes. Dan Rascone talked with one teacher who sees his auto mechanics program on the chopping block.
The other thing you're going to notice on here
is a temperature of 160.
Today, just about every chair is taken in Jacob Bagnell's automotive class. He says this illustrates the interest high school students have in engine work. But the problem is there's no money in the school district to keep up with the growing number of interested students.
Right now, I have to restrict the kids on what they can do here. And that's ridiculous. You do not restrict students from working. I'm supposed to be pushing them into working. That's my job.
The cutbacks have hurt us so bad we can't finish a lot of our projects.
What frustrates Bagnell the most is a ranking the automotive class receives from the district. He says body shop is just as, or more important, than English, math, or history.
Nowadays, everybody either wants their kids to go to a four-year university, and you're getting kids in colleges and universities that should never be there. They're going out of 4 years, and they still don't have a trade or vocation. Then they have to start all over again.
Starting all over again is what Bagnell is having to do. Since he can't get any money from the district to expand, he plans to raise it himself. So he's holding a car show sponsored by several companies throughout the county.
The car show will be held here on the football field this Saturday. Bagnell says there'll be more than 150 cars on display. Plus, they'll be giving away engines, transmissions, and other car parts. The price is $2 a person. Dan Rascone, 10 News, Santana High School.
There is some good news for consumers today. The gasoline to fuel those cars is getting a little cheaper. Right now, you're going to be able to find unleaded regular gasoline at some stations in San Diego below $1 a gallon. It's partially because local station owners are paying less for gasoline than those in Orange and Los Angeles counties. Meanwhile, industry analysts say there is a nationwide glut in the gasoline market right now because many people started driving less when the new tax hikes raised fuel prices at the pump. Well, imagine paying more for water than you do for property taxes. Mayor Maureen O'Connor believes that that could happen. O'Connor is calling for the Public Utilities Commission to regulate the state's water system to keep that from happening. Senator Wadi Deda is joining the mayor to introduce some legislation that would require public agencies that sell water to answer to the PUC. Mayor O'Connor says that she wants to stop the Metropolitan Water District's plans to raise San Diego's water rates by 78% next year. Two California condors are close to finding freedom in the wild. Both of these condors were actually born in captivity as part of the ongoing effort to save the giant birds from extinction. This morning, they are being held in a netted pen near Los Padres National Forest, and they will be released into the wild sometime about the first of the year. Still, biologists say they are going to help the birds fend for food after they are set free. Here's what's making headlines around the world this morning. Police in New Jersey say that a fired postal worker accused of killing four people intended to kill even more. Joseph Harris faces murder charges in connection with yesterday's killing spree. Police say that Harris killed a former supervisor and her boyfriend in a nearby town before going to the post office where he once worked and started shooting the first two employees to arrive for work. Harris was fired from his job last year as a mail sorter because he had threatened and harassed other employees at the post office. California gay activists are converging on the state capitol this morning to protest Governor Wilson's veto of AB 101. Organizers expect tens of thousands of people to show up at a massive rally in Sacramento. Protesters are angry that Wilson rejected a bill that would have barred job discrimination against gays and lesbians. A special bird is spreading its growing wings at SeaWorld this morning. When this tiny penguin chipped out of its avocado-sized shell last month, it had only a 20% chance to live. Within 3 weeks of hand-rearing, the rare emperor chick has become much stronger.
We get a fish frozen, and we start out with a few grams of fish every other feeding when he's young, and now he's getting 30 grams of fish each feeding, depending on how much they weigh.
The hatching of this emperor chick is only the 12th successive captive hatching in zoological history. Emperors are the largest of 17 penguin species, reaching a height of 3 to 4 feet. It is now 10:53. You are up to date. Once again, here is Laura on Inside San Diego.
That deserves an ah, doesn't
it? It does indeed.
Okay.
There's nothing cuter than a penguin chick.
Yeah, a chick. That's the operative word there. Thank you. You know, if you've ever been driving alone and had to pull off the freeway with a flat tire, would it be great to have some instant help from real pros? Well, Bill is outside the studio to show us what a difference they would make.
It would be great, wouldn't it, Laura, if out of the bushes alongside the freeway, a half a dozen able-bodied folks were to jump out and take care of those little problems for us. Well, of course, we're not driving million-dollar race cars, but they will be this weekend at the Del Mar Fairgrounds. So we have Steve Millen here, factory driver for Nissan, to tell us a little bit about the pit crew and their importance, and we have six of Nissan's finest arrayed behind us. How important are these folks to you, Steve?
Bill, these guys are really important. We've won three of the last four races, and a good part of those wins has been the pit crew. These guys are the best.
Why?
Because, you know, you can drive, you know, flat out on the track all the time and take risks and passing other people and so on. But if you get held up in the pits at all, you've wasted your time and taken some risks that are unnecessary. And we never lose a pit stop. We're always better than the other teams.
How often do you have to pit? Do you have to come into the pits during a race?
The races vary in length, and sometimes we have two or three pit stops. But in this particular race at Del Mar, there won't be any pit stops, we hope.
You just go from beginning to end.
Hopefully.
Now, I got a point. Steve's been saying these guys, but you got to take a look in the back row there. Raise your hand, Elizabeth. Elizabeth Kelsey is the only woman pit crew member in IMSA Racing, right?
That's what I believe.
And a very talented young lady she is, too. It's not easy. All right, Steve, you want to show us, put these folks through their paces and show us what to do? Get in and fire up the GTO. Look really easy. You think I could do that?
No.
Go down at nighttime. Play music in the bars.
Love it! He got just what he deserved. Okay, coming up next, we're gonna have one of man's best friends, that is Dr. Dennis Vetko, Dr. Dog, giving you some tips on how to train that puppy that may be a little tough to discipline.
I feel good talking to you about Elme. I believe in Elme. For almost 60 years, Elme has created the products that help keep our skin cared for, protected, beautiful, always effective, always sensitive, always hypoallergenic. Like Elme Cold Cream. It's as gentle as it is thorough. It doesn't strip your skin or clog your pores. It leaves skin clean and cared for. I really believe in Elme.
For one day only, this Sunday, Collector's Hunt returns to the San Diego area for our first sale of the new season. To sell out over 2,000 beautiful oil paintings at $39 or less. Giant sofa-size oils, $39. Incredible! In addition to these paintings, hundreds of our gallery-quality oils like you see here at unbelievably low prices. But this event will last just one day. Don't miss Collector's Hunt. This Sunday only, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. In San Diego at the DoubleTree Hotel in Mission Valley. In Carlsbad at Pisup Anderson's. And in Rancho Bernardo at the Rancho Bernardo Inn.
Grossmont Nutrition is selling their all-occasion greeting cards for only 30 cents each, four for a dollar. No one beats our prices. Great selection only at Grossmont Nutrition in Grossmont Center.
It won't kill you to go out with him once. You're not getting any younger, you know.
My head.
And he's a very successful mortician.
Where's my Anacin 3?
To relieve a splitting headache, reach for Anacin 3. It's strong, and Anacin 3 is 100% aspirin-free.
Glad you're feeling better. Cecil's here.
Anacin 3, aspirin-free pain relief for splitting headaches.
I was just gonna, is your dog a jumper? Yes. A digger? A barker? Annoying? And are you contributing to that undesired behavior by giving your pet mixed signals? Most of us don't know about dog psychology to figure that out. That's why every month we bring on respected animal behaviorist Dr. Dennis Vetko, Dr. Dog, to straighten us out, not to mention the dog. In our next segment, Dr. Dog will take your calls. Well, actually, he won't because we only have a little bit of limited time. But in the meantime, you are going to meet Domino, okay? There is Domino, a 13-month-old Dalmatian who was owned by 10 News producer Janine Carrillo. Okay, now Janine says Domino can be trying. She has a gift for understatement, and she needs a little help from Dr. Dog. So good morning to you, and hello, Domino.
Good morning.
All right. This is the first question I will ask you, and I'll tell you some specifics that Janine gave me about Domino's behavior. Breed specific, Dalmatians, are there peculiar characteristics, you know, unique to them, behavioral things?
There really are, and how good that we have a Dal to talk about. First of all, genetic and congenital dysfunctions. For some reason, the dog has a very, very high probability of deafness. Genetic and congenital deafness. Oh. And you have no idea how many of these dogs are reprimanded very harshly for not obeying your command, and they're not disobeying you, they didn't hear it. So that's number one. In fact, any of the breed that has albinism in its line, and these dogs are obviously pretty white except for the spots, albinism and party-colored eyes, when you see one blue and one brown. Apparently the gene that affects deafness or hearing impairment also affects those things. So number one, it's always a good idea to test the dog's hearing and do it consistently throughout the life of the Dal.
Because you could think you have
a bad dog. That's right, and he's just not hearing you.
What else?
Oh, the other thing, by the way, is that if the dog is hearing impaired, you're going to see a lovely, affectionate animal because all of your reprimands are lost to it, okay? So it's very approach-oriented, and oftentimes people say, my dog is so loving and affectionate, it can't be deaf. And amazingly enough, that's a clue.
Okay, in the time we have, I want to make sure that we understand a lot of the complaints, the things that Janine talks about, are other dogs, you know,